Welcome to CJ Square Math Tutorials. Today I am your host Jasmine Wilson along with Sienna Jarvis and Jaleel Reed. Today we will explain the extreme value
theorem. The conditions of the extreme value theorem include that f of x must be continuous on the closed interval a and b, which we can conclude that f of x will obtain both absolute minimum and maximum value on the closed interval a and b.
Hi, I'm Sienna Jarvis, and I'm going to be showing you an example of when the conditions of the extreme value theorem are not met so that the extreme value theorem cannot be applied. So we're going to start with the function f of x equals x squared minus x minus 2 all over x plus 1. There's a couple reasons why this function is discontinuous, including that there's a hole at x equals negative 1. A hole in the graph would make the rational function both the numerator and denominator equal to 0. And to prove it, I'm going to work it out for you guys.
So f of negative 1 equals negative 1 squared minus negative 1 minus 2 all over negative 1 plus 1. We're not even going to do any bad algebra, guys. Let's check this out. 1 plus 1 minus 2 over negative 1 plus 1. So this would be 2 minus 2, which would be 0. And then negative 1 plus 1 would be 0. And as I said earlier, a hole in a rational function is when the numerator and denominator both are 0 over 0, which would make this function discontinuous and you can't apply the extreme value theorem.
My name is Jaleel Reed, and I'll be explaining where you can use the extreme value theorem to find the absolute min or max value on a function. So we have a problem function f of x equal to 2x cubed plus 3x squared minus. To see if we can actually apply the extreme value theorem to this function, we have to see if the conditions are met. First, we need to see if the function is continuous, and we can clearly see it's continuous because it's a polynomial, and it's also on a closed interval, which is from negative 1 to 2. So now we have to find the critical points for this function. So we'll take the derivative of the function, and we'll see that it's 6x squared plus 6x minus 12. And we can find a common factor of 6 in this function. X minus 2. And we can factor it further, and we'll see that f prime of x will be equal to 6 times x plus 2 times x minus 1. And then we can see that the critical points will be, if you set these both equal to 0, you'll see that the critical points will be negative 2 and 1. And we found the critical points. Now we must plug in negative 2, 1, negative 1, and 2 to see where we can find the absolute min and max. So we'll plug those numbers into the original function.
We have f of negative 2, f negative 1, f of 1, and f of 2.
But as we can see, we still have to apply the conditions to this function, and we can see that f of negative 2 is not within the closed interval. So we can cross this out. Plug in f of negative 1 into the function, you will get negative 2, 3, 12, and then of course plus 1, and you'll get the value 14. And for f of 1, you get 2, 3, negative 12, plus 1, and that would be negative 7. And then for f of 2, you'll get 16, 12, negative 24, plus 1. And when you get that, you'll get negative 12 plus 16, which will equal to 4. And now you can see the highest value is 14. That means that there's a local maximum at f equals negative 1. And you can also see there's a local minimum at f equals 1, because this is a negative 7, which is the lowest value. So we can conclude that f of negative 1, which is equal to 14, is the absolute maximum, and f of 1 that equals to negative 7 would be the absolute minimum.